Are we using it properly? That's a very important question which we have to ask. So if, as we move from 40 to 60 years of age, because most of you are in that age group, so I thought we have to know what is actually happening. So this is what our body function happens. When we are between 20 to 35, we see that a lot of muscle mass which is present, and we see that the fat mass is less. As we grow older, by 65, the amount of muscle mass is going to come down, and we see that the fat mass is picking up more. And that is called sarcopenia, which is the anomaly which is physiologically which we have. So if that is the case, what is being seen across the world is 50% of the older adults, they don't use the muscles. And we can also be stronger at any age of our time, only if we use it. So what is actually happening? Let me explain you this diagram. I want all of you to have a look at it, because this is what we are actually undergoing. So if you are going to be a healthy individual, this is how it is. When you are going to walk, you are going to do the physical activity, this is how it is going to be, the muscle mass break. But when, as we are becoming older and we are not using the muscles, at least if you are not using it for 10 days of inactivity, you can see here the muscles in the legs, it's all going to go down. And then as we grow older, or if you are going to be hospitalized, what happens is we are actually, even 3 days if we are going to be hospitalized, then more than 10% of the lean body mass is being used. We are going to lose it. And so what happens at the age of 40 years? Almost 8% of the patients at this time, they start losing the lean body mass. But when we are becoming 70 years, 25% of the lean body mass is lost. So that is called sarcopenia. This is Pete said that it is one of the four major reasons of the loss of muscle, next to anorexia, dehydration and cachexia. If that is the case, what happens is when we are going to use our muscle, when we are going to be active 5 to 10 years, we can be younger. We think that we are younger, but what happens is physically we are losing. As the previous speakers are all talking about, we are not able to walk or we are not able to do our physical activity itself. So where are we going to use the muscles properly? So what happens when you are at 40 years, this much of muscles you are having. But by the 70, you can see here, we have lost the muscles. And because of that, we are not able to climb stairs. We started using lift. And wherever we are going, we can see when 2 decades before, there was not escalators which were present everywhere. But we can see now all these escalators are there, and we are using that. We are used to use that rather than walking and going. So, and because of that, by about 50 years, 1 in 3 adults have become sarcopenic. Now, there are studies which has been done across the world. What does it show? You can see here in India, the sarcopenia is 17.5. This is the maximum in different countries put together. We don't have, we are not coming to the sarcopenic obesity, which is prevalent in all other countries. Even we are actually slowly catching up on that aspect also. So how are we going to identify this part is, the symptoms are body becomes weak, reduced physical activity, and also muscle loss is happening. So now, when you are in the 40 years, what happens is that's a time where we have started losing all our muscles. So this is a time where you start losing it by the help of the hand grip itself, you can easily identify. But we don't notice that much and we just ignore it. But when we are going to 60 years of age, by that time, you would have lost 20% of the total muscle mass. By 65, the chances of the fall is going to be on a higher side. If we even a trip, we might fall down and we break our legs. So what happens? How are we going to identify? This is how it can be identified. There are, if any two of the three criteria are there, either low muscle mass, low muscle strength, or low physical performance. If it is going to be there, then we have started losing our lean body mass. That is the sarcopenia. How to identify it? There are a lot of research which are going on. I'm not going to touch upon the research, but how are we going to identify it in our day-to-day clinic? So this is how to identify the muscle mass. We can easily identify with the help of anthropometry, then bioelectrical impedance, or DEXA. If it is going to be the strength, this is what it can be easily identified. How is with the help of the hand grip strength? Hand grip strength is, if you have come last month, I was just showing you how to do it with a dynamometer. So that is the easiest point which you can see whether how much is your muscle strength which is there for each bus, because that is going to tell you whether you are strong, you are weak. That can, you can actually easily identify that. And then physical performance, how to do that? We cannot ask them to go on a treadmill and then do it, it's very difficult. So how to do it is with a short physical performance battery, or we can use it with a gait speed and also timed up and go. So normally how fast we are going to go on a walk, that also can be identified. And are we supposed to look into the BMI? Because what we normally do is we do the BMI and we don't, what is happening to the lean body mass? I'll just take you through that. So what happens is, whenever we are going to take a BMI, we think that the BMI of a person is almost the same as when two persons are being identified. You can see here, both of them are looking the same. But what happens for the, if you're going to take the BMI, both of them are same. But what happens to the lean body mass? You can see here, this person, the lean body mass is very good because he has done a lot of exercise and other things. Whereas here, this person also BMI is same. But this is not actually, we can see that he has lost a lot of muscle. So we have to make sure that the muscle friendly food choices we have to do. How to go about? There are three things which we have to do. One is eat more protein and vitamin D. The next is add weight to your walks. Not just walking is going to help you, because it's just the walking. We have to also add weights to it and some aerobic exercise if possible as age advances. If you're not going to have any physical problem, then you can actually do some aerobic exercise. So we have to take care of all the nutrition part. It should be a complete and balanced nutrition whenever we are taking. It should not be more of carbohydrates. If you see the plate which is being given, it is almost 80 to 90% is carbohydrate. So we have to change the way we are going to eat. So let me show you how we are supposed to eat. If a person is going to take more, say the breakfast, lunch or dinner, if he is going to take proteins, if it is going to be on a same level, adequate amount of protein is being taken, that is how the maximum synthesis happens. Where when you are taking more in dinner, you might think that you are taking more of the protein. But what happens is the inadequate distribution takes place. There is also another thing which we have to keep in mind is the resistant exercise. If we are going to do a resistant exercise, we are actually able to, and that is the time where the muscle is being broken. That time when you take the most more of the amino acid, you are going to have a protein synthesis which is happening. So this is a pyramid. We know that we have seen a lot of pyramids in our life, and we have seen that the last one is not being shown to us at all in any of the meetings which we go. This is the most important one. We can see here, we all talk about what we have to eat, we have to drink this much of glasses of water and everything. But the last one is most important. If you are not having a maid in your house, sweep the house. We have to do it. At least a small physical act. We are not going to go out and do it. At least that is an exercise which you are doing. Not just sitting in front of the TV and seeing it. What's the best exercise we can do is sit in the front of the TV, take a 1 liter bottle, water bottle, 1 liter which is there, and at least do your biceps work. Because there's no point in watching the news for hours to get the same news in all channels you're going to watch it. Better at least when there's exciting news, just do it very fast. So that you are actually using your muscles. That's a very important one. And we have seen that there are hours together we are sitting in front of TV and we are not wasting all our muscles. Instead of that, if we can use those muscles, we are not going to lose it, and it is going to be very helpful as we grow older. So the right exercise and right diet is more important. I just want to ask you, how many of you eat your lunch at 12:30 to 1? Can you raise your hands? No, sir. There are 5 of them are eating that time. But that is the time where we are peak, we get a lot of patients and we are actually very busy. But we are supposed to eat at the right time. That's another important thing which we have to do. So there are clinical evidences which I have seen. I'll just show you one RCT which is being done. It was done with the Cochrane Lethalink, where they wanted to analyze the effectiveness of the exercise, the drugs which we take, the combination intervention for treating sarcopenia and older people. It seems that it actually improves the muscle mass, muscle strength, and also if you give a nutritional intervention.
Is there any study in India which has shown that when we give a nutritional intervention, is there improvement in the patients?
So there was one study which was done in India. It was a randomized open label trial in 212 patients. What they did was they gave oral nutritional supplement. They used one product of Ensure and they gave dietary counseling. The other group received dietary counseling. So what actually happened, you can see here, this was a 12-week study. When they gave an oral nutritional supplement, there was a very good improvement in the patient's weight, as well as the weight gain was also very good. Compared to the control group, when the oral nutritional supplement was given, BMI also was increased, and also the amount of energy taken was also very high. So when they give a complete and balanced nutrition, the patient actually, all the patients as well as us, we are going to get the calories which is required. Not really just taking the carbohydrate, we have to take a complete and balanced nutrition. So aging is natural. We have to make sure that we don't lose our muscles. So thank you.
Thank you very much for the very active talk. Now I request Dr. Venkat sir, your past question to hand over the same kind of organization.
Okay,